Hi there, welcome back to this second part of my interview. The retired Lieutenant General is a man throughout Madagascar. I mean, the few people I've spoken to is like, you are seriously respected in this country.
Merci. En tout cas, je crois que
one of the biggest challenges is to be loved by God and respected by men. Often we children of God are satisfied to be loved by God and do not seek to live lives that command the respect of men. Even Christ was loved by God and respected by men.
What do you think when we call your name everywhere I go? I mean, the few people I've spoken to, like that man is with a lot of respect. Why do you think it's so?
It is pleasing to have this reputation, and at the same time, it places a sense of responsibility on me. Because when you are held in such high esteem nationally, and you commit even the smallest of fault, this can destroy your testimony. That is why I said we must not only be satisfied to be loved by God, but we must seek to have a good testimony of our life before men.
So it's not just enough to say God loves me, I'm okay with God. What is your testimony with men?
Yes, because we are called to be the salt of the earth and the light of this world. Our lives can draw men to Christ or drive men away from Christ. My second challenge is the family. To live out your faith in your family, not as a burden you place on people in your family, but rather as a love that is shared by all. Often we impose the things we believe and love on our family, such that it becomes a weight on them. We need, by the grace of God, to be fathers by God's wisdom who are able to inspire the family to love them. This is important because sometimes we neglect our family and we so-called Christians with very unhappy homes. You can be a father who is successful with children who have abandoned the faith. These are responsibilities God has given us as much as the call to serve our country.
La première chose que Dieu a donné avant la nation, c'est la famille.
How have you managed that? You've been married for how many years?
Je me suis marié très jeune.
I was married at a very young age. I have been with my wife for 45 years, and we have 2 children and 7 grandchildren. My first grandchild is presently 17 years old. That will give you an idea of how young I was when I got married.
Have you managed to balance this call to the family and your call to the public service? How?
Je vais d'abord préciser que.
Let me say this: I am not perfect. When I say I've been married since 1980, I experienced marriage with Christ and also marriage without Christ. I have the experience of being a father without God and then a father with God. I don't want to talk about my life without Christ because it is filled with things that I regret, things that I did without the knowledge of Christ. And now that I have grown in Christ, I do not want my children to want to live that kind of life without God. A husband without God is one who does whatever he pleases. You can imagine what I was like as a young officer without Christ, the kind of suffering my wife went through. This is why I give priority to my family since I've met Christ. It is important that you train your family in Christ if you do not want them to walk in your former ways. I know the difference now.
It's Christ that made the difference.
Yeah, c'est très important de la différence. Et
with all your responsibility or work, it is never an excuse to not take charge of your family. If you cannot manage your family, how can you manage the nation? And God gives us grace to handle all this responsibility He has placed on us. God grants us the wisdom and the grace to handle all of this in this world full of divorce and family breakdown.
Dans ce monde où il y a de plus en plus de divorces.
As you're speaking now, if you're a politician, I'll just vote for you. But somebody will say, if we have such men in government, why are we not seeing changes?
Le développement n'est pas.
Development is not first of all a matter of the government and what they do. Development is first of all a state of mind before it is an economic state. I believe that we need to fight against this mentality to get our people to the place where they no longer accept this state of poverty. The government is supposed to help and bring the expertise, but the war against poverty demands a change of mentality. There are traditions that we have that hinder our development. So as Christians, we must preach the truth so that the truth will liberate people.
Pour que la vérité a franchi.
Now, we're landing this. We're coming to a landing. I want you to look into the camera and speak to some people are in your position. Others are young people aspiring tomorrow to be there. Your advice to us as Christians. You talked about being salt and light. I want you to speak to us. Yeah.
Je parle aux frères et aux sœurs africains.
I speak to my brothers and sisters. God requires two things from us. That we have not just the salvation by faith, but also the wisdom of God, because He calls us to be salt and light. And if we do not shine where we are, others will take our place. That is why I say we need wisdom, not when we go to heaven, but for our time here in this world. And to those who have the privilege of serving in government, you will govern, leaders of this continent. I want you to know that all these positions will not last forever. Please be true to who you are. Be first of all faithful to your Lord, even before being faithful to your government or party. For if we guard our allegiance to Jesus, then we will be true agents of development for our continent.
Si nous gardons fermement ces valeurs, je crois que c'est pas contraire à toute politique de développement.
Thank you so much. Is there something else you would like to say?
Je veux également.
And finally, I encourage our youth to aspire to be responsible leaders. Remember that as a Christian, God wants to place you in high position. He wants to use you to change your country. So be diligent where you are right now. Be the best you can be everywhere. And when you are the best where you are, this will glorify your Father in heaven.
Soyez bon partout, be the best. Et quand on est le meilleur là où nous sommes, ça ne fait que glorifier notre Dieu qui est dans le ciel.
Wonderful. What do you see as the future of Madagascar?
Je reste toujours confiant.
I believe that just as God can bless a man, He also can bless a nation. But when God wants to bless a nation, He always calls the people to repentance. If the people will repent, God commits Himself to pouring out His blessings.
Si le peuple se repent, si le peuple revient à Dieu, Dieu s'engage à guérir le pays et Dieu s'engage à développer ce pays.
Thank you so much for sharing. Amen. Thank you for having us in your home.
It's a pleasure.
This is where we begin to draw the curtain. It's so beautiful to be in warm Madagascar and to hear these warm stories. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.